Now. Welcome, CFTN family. How are you doing tonight? Come on, how are you feeling today? It's a good day. It's a good day to be in the house of God. I'm just looking around. I want you to feel as comfortable as possible. Go ahead and stand to your feet. Say hi to the person next to you. And now that you feel comfortable, I want to invite you closer. Just come to the front. Get closer. We're family. We all smell good. I don't know about you, but it excites me every time it's Wednesday evening and it's time to come together to just worship the name of Jesus. There's nothing better that we get to do than just come as family, as one, and lift up the name of Jesus together. Lifting up the name of Jesus as one. Father, we come before you tonight. For you alone are worthy. You alone deserve all of the praise and all of the glory. God, nothing else matters in this moment. Nothing else matters in this moment, God. Whatever happened Monday, Tuesday, and today throughout the day, God, we just put that on the side and we intentionally choose to focus on you, God. We give you priority tonight. And God, we just give you room. We give you room for you to do whatever it is that you want to do in this place, God. Come have your way. And we give you the highest praise. We give you the highest praise, for only you deserve it all. So receive our worship tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, let's give him the highest praise together, church.
Still you're here with us, blessed be just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see. My heart can help but believe. There's nothing that a God can't do. Come on, let's lift it up. A mountain that He can move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that a God can't do. Tonight, do you come expecting Jesus can do anything? Let's declare it. I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise. Let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe for greater things. No power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise. Let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Come on, I will believe. I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Oh, let faith arise. Let all agree. There's no power. Not a mountain. Oh, praise His name. That makes a way. Yeah. God of nothing. Nothing that a God can't do. There's not a prison wall He can't break through. Oh, praise the name. That makes a way. Tonight, Lord, we trust you. Oh, we believe. churning it around. You're churning it around. You're churning it around and around and around. You're turning around. You're turning around. You turn it around and around and around and around. You are for me. You're not against me. You're fighting for.
Things, there's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise and all agree, there's no power like the power of Jesus. We will believe for greater things, there's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise and all agree, there's no power like the power of Jesus. There's no power like His power. There's no one like You, Jesus. There's no power like Your power, Lord. Hey. We've come to worship. We've come to surrender all to You. Nothing else matters but seeing You, Jesus. Come on, speak to Him tonight. Say, I can't get enough. No, I can't get enough of Your amazing love. No, I can't get enough. And I can't walk away. No, I can't walk away, for I have seen Your face, and now I can't walk away, and I just wanna be where You are. I just wanna be near Your heart, Jesus. For there is nothing like Your love. There is nothing like Your love, oh Jesus. There's nothing like. Heart to say to Jesus tonight,
I can't get enough.
just want to be where you are. Just want to be where you are. Right here in your presence. Right here in your presence. I find fullness of joy. I find fullness of joy. Right here in your presence. Right here in your presence. I find peace. I find love. I find shelter. Yes, I do. Right here in your presence. Presence. I've searched the world and I found nothing like you, Jesus. I've searched the world and I found no one like you, Jesus. No one like you, none beside you, no one. For you are holy, holy, yeah. Holy, holy, you are holy. Jesus, I love you. You are. Forever. Three times. Jesus, I love. The train of your own fills the temple. The train of your own fills the temple. We see. If we bow and see. Jesus, I love you. Oh, how I love you. Oh, how I love you. You are the one my heart adores, my heart surrenders. Jesus, I love you. Oh, I
Oh, can you just take a second and pour out your love to Jesus tonight?
Oh, I pour out my love to you. My worship is yours. My worship is yours. Here it is. Here it is. I'm not holding back, no, no. 'Cause I love you. Yes, I love you. And Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I love you. Oh, how I love you. Oh, how I love you. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, for you are the of it all. And you are the of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
The posture of surrender, we say,
you are the of it all. Yeah. You are the of it all.
All glory, all honor is yours.
For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
Have this on my heart right now. Yes, God. I remember a moment in my life at my lowest point that all I learned to do is worship. Yeah. And I found that in every moment that I chose to worship at my lowest point, God always met me. And I didn't worship him to feel good about myself. I worshiped him because of who he was. And see, even in that moment, I didn't know who he was in that moment, but when I began to lift up my voice and I began to lift up my song, he began to reveal who he was and who he always wanted to be in my life. And my only response in that moment was, Jesus, you're holy. Jesus, you're worthy. Jesus, you're deserving. At my last breath, you're worthy. At my first breath, you're worthy. No matter what I'm facing. Yes. And then I remember singing this. Only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. There's only one word that comes to my mind. There's only one word to describe. Then I just said to him, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty. Jesus, you're holy, holy. Just right now, over your situation, sing that. There is no one like you. You are holy, holy. Jesus, there is no
cast our cares on.
Your blood runs through our veins.
you declare that one more time? Sing, come alive.
Come alive. We sing, come alive. This is a house of miracles. We bring everything to the feet of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. This is not just a song. What he's saying is true. Times and times again, we've seen miracles in this place. And when Pastor Daniel said the king is in this place, we know tonight that Jehovah Jireh is here.
Yes.
Jehovah Rapha is here.
Yes.
Jehovah Nissi is here. Any breakthrough you need, just come to him. You know, I love your testimony, Pastor Daniel. God is so faithful. And he craves intimacy with us. Even when we run away from him, he still pursues us. And when you are at your lower place, but you call on him, he will meet you there. So tonight, I just want to encourage you. Say it's your night. Tell yourself that God who is here for you. And he will respond to you. Father God, we praise you tonight. We thank you for your presence in this place. We thank you because you are the provider. You are the healer. You are our banner. You are our peace. You are righteousness. You are our all in all. And we thank you that you're here tonight. And that you'll meet your sons and your daughters who are crying out to you. You know their needs. And you will provide. You will meet their need according to your riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for everything you've already done so far. Thank you for the amazing things you're going to do tonight. And Father, we continue to lift up Israel to you. Father, we pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And we trust you that regardless of whatever is happening, you're still in control. And you have everything in your hands. So, Father, we pray that you have your way. And that you reveal yourself in a mighty way to those who don't know you. But we pray also that your people come to know the Messiah, Jesus. Father, we thank you for what you're going to do tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you for being here tonight. Thank you, Worship Nation. You guys are awesome. Hallelujah. I just want to welcome you to the Wednesday night service. And sometimes they call it the service for the crazies. But it's awesome that you're here. And I want to welcome all those who are watching us online. And I pray that the miracles, the amazing things that we're going to experience in this place tonight, you too, you'll experience it in your homes. For those who don't know me, my name is Kwame. And I've been at CFTN for the past, 16 years. I'm one of the pastors. I lead outreach with my wife and also the prayer team. And you are going to suffer me tonight. So I'm so excited to give you tonight the opportunity to bless God with your first fruits. And We know that God loves cheerful givers because Himself is more than a cheerful giver. John 3:16 say God loves, so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, Jesus, who came and died for us. Jesus didn't hesitate once to give His life so that we can live, so that we can come closer to Him. And by giving, what we do is we move ourselves towards the image of Christ. We want to be like Him. We sing all the time, we want to be like you. We want to know you, we want to be like you. And you cannot be like Jesus without being a giver. So tonight, if you've never done it before, I want to encourage you. For some of us who have been giving for I don't know how long, God's providence never failed us. So I just want to encourage you to do it and see what God will do in your life. So let's pray for the offerings. Father, we thank You for tonight. Thank You for blessing Your sons and Your daughters. Thank You for opening the floodgates of heaven and pour out all the blessings that are due them over them. And tonight I ask You to bless their offering. I ask You to take them, multiply them, and just give it back to them in due season. We praise You. We honor You. We glorify You. We magnify You and we sanctify You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Please give. The buckets are in the front here. And what's the announcement?
What is up, CFTN family? If you are new, we are so glad you're here. We have a connect card in the seat pocket in front of you. Fill it out, drop it in the offering bucket or our drop box in the north lobby. If you're watching online, connect using our chat or website at cftn.com/now. Here's what's happening at CFTN. Men, brothers, brethren, bros, dads, uncles, husbands, we have a grill and chill this Thursday full of worship, food, and fellowship. So be there at 6:30 in the warehouse. CFTN Fall Collection is here. We will be selling everything in our merch room in the courtyard today. You don't want to miss out on all our new styles.
Hey parents, I'm Madison and I'm the Family Life Worship Director.
And I'm Isaiah, I'm Worship Nation's Junior Music Director.
Do you have a middle or high schooler that likes to sing or play an instrument?
The CFTN Youth Worship Team will be holding auditions on Sunday, October 22nd at 1:30 p.m. in the warehouse upstairs.
Come prepared to sing What I See by Elevation Worship.
If you're interested, you can scan this QR code and sign up.
We hope to see you there.
Absolutely.
What is the heart of God? What is my calling?
Does God require more from me than just going to church? When I get filled, do I pour out?
So the question is, what will you do with what has been freely given to you?
Proverbs 19:17. If you help the poor, you are lending to the Lord, and He will repay you. Matthew 25:40. I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. Matthew 28:19. Go, therefore I make disciples of all nations. Church for the Nations is founded on the premise of outreach to all nations. We are giving you the opportunity on November 11th to join all of our staff for Reach Day, where we will be leading 8 different serving and outreach opportunities. So, the question is, what will you do with what has freely been given to you?
It was a late night in October. I just solved the case of the golden goose. a hard, long case. I was tired. I just wanted to rest a while and put my feet up when my whole life changed. There was a knock at the door. I was about to yell at the person to leave me alone when the door opened. There, standing at the door, Vanessa Winter, actress, model, and full-time janitor. I knew it was serious when she gave me the look.
I gave him the look because it was serious. How was I going to convince him how serious this was? What was I going to tell him to make him help me?
This is serious.
I knew it was serious, but I needed more time and more information on this case. I had so many questions. Why was she here? What kind of trouble must she be in to need my help? And why are those bite-sized Snickers so good?
I closed the door to let him know that I meant business, and this was important.
I knew she meant business, so I tried to act professionally to show her that whatever the case was, I was her guy. I just asked her to come in and have a seat.
Have a seat.
He seemed a little slow, but I knew he could get the job done. I started to tell him the story. It was Halloween last year, and I wanted to do something with my kid. Something special, something different. So I took him to the haunted house. It was supposed to be fun, they said. They were wrong.
I hate to see a lady cry, so I knew I needed help. I offered her some tissues.
Here's some tissues.
Thanks. That was very nice of him to give me some tissues. But I didn't come here for tissues. I needed answers, and I needed them fast.
This was going to be tough. How was I going to solve this case? I needed some more time to think. I had to distract her with something to buy some more time.
Have some candy.
He is so nice, but I could tell that he is lost in thought, trying to figure out a solution to my problem.
I was lost in thought trying to solve the case. I needed to get some more answers to some very tough questions like, why does she keep taking my stuff? Is there a Halloween event that is safe and fun for the whole family? And what costume is Pastor Mike going to wear? I needed some more time.
I need more time.
I knew I could count on him. I wish there was a way to thank him for his kindness, plus his gifts.
Thank you so much. I can't wait to hear back from you.
She was turning to leave. I kept feeling I was missing something, like there was something that was so obvious I couldn't put my finger on. But I couldn't. What could it be? I don't know. I had to think of something.
Hey, here. Take this flyer that my friend Akin dropped off.
As I stood there reading this flyer, I realized that he just handed me the answer to my problem. He was truly a genius. This man has saved Halloween for me and my family.
Thank you so much. The fest, you're a genius. Thank you.
I knew I did it. If I had a dollar for every time I was called a genius, I would have a dollar. It would be a long and difficult night trying to figure out what just happened.
Thank you so much for being a part of our service. Follow us on our YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram at CFTNAZ. Enjoy this amazing message and the rest of service.
Okay. How are you doing? Yep. Tonight, I wanted to share with you about something. You know, since I knew that I would talk to you, my topic changed at least twice. And, you know, we live in a world that is in turmoil. And I told you before, here that I've been so blessed in my life to work with people. I've been blessed to be here at the altar sometime, praying with people. And one thing that I realized, and we all went through that, it's sometimes we lack the presence. We lack the presence of God. We go through things, and that's where we realize that we needed God. While God's presence has to be permanent in our life. I said before during the transition that God craves intimacy with us. He created us for fellowship. He created us to spend time with us. And even when sin came in and we were separated from him, he did not hesitate to send his son to die for us so that we can come back to him. And now, because sin came in, sometimes we struggle. We struggle. You'll be walking with God, and then, you know, so the Bible will say, the flesh wars against the things of the spirit. So today, I just want to share with you some little things, probably that many of you know, but it's about walking with the Lord. And I chose Psalm 84, which is one of the most beautiful psalms about the presence of the Lord, dwelling in the house of the Lord. And it reads, "How lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, yes, even faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young, even your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Blessed are those who dwell in your house. They will still be praising you, Selah. Blessed is the man whose strength is in you, whose heart is set on pilgrimage. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a spring. The rain also covers it with pools. They go from strength to strength. Each one appears before God in Zion. O Lord, God of hosts, hear my prayer. Give ear, O God of Jacob, Selah. O God, behold your shield, and look upon the face of your anointed. For a day in your court is better than a thousand. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of wickedness. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from those who walk uprightly. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man who trusts you." No. Our life, God designed it to be happy. God designed us to always feel him, to feel his warm embrace, to walk with him, regardless of what we are going through. Because if the need of breakthrough is what only draws us to God, the first thing is that we'll have a very difficult journey, and it's not going to be easy. I remember somebody told me, they prayed for a lady who said, "Yes, I pray to God, I want my healing, but I've never sought him." But it needs to be the other way around. You need to seek God. Seek him with all your heart. And when you live that type of life with God, you don't even feel what you're going through. When you put yourself in the presence of the Lord, because the main thing is the presence. When you live in the presence of the Lord, the rest is his. The battle is his. Sometimes we are so overwhelmed by what the enemy is doing in our lives that we forget that we have God. And sometimes even we try to put the devil at the level of God. The devil is not God's, you know, counterpart. God created him. And then he ran away from it. He became one of the fallen angels. He rebelled against God. God created him. And the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 6, don't you know that you will judge the angels? What does that mean? That means that you're above them. You're above the demons. You're above all those things. So you first need to think that they're beneath you. They will try to attack you because they're dumb. That's what they do. But they will win if you allow them. You have to see yourself above them. So, for you to be able to enjoy God, come to that level where you will know nothing can move you, you have to walk with God 24/7. That's what I will say. We come to church Sundays or Wednesday nights. We praise God. We worship him. We enjoy him. We live in his presence when we come here. But how is it when we go out? How do we spend our Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, or even the rest of Sundays? How do we behave when we are at work? Do we still walk with God when we are in environments that are not godly? Because in the world we live in today, we are surrounded by so much ungodly things. Do we compromise? Do we follow the crowd? Are we fearful to stand alone sometimes? Because when you walk with God, you have to be. So, the first thing we need to understand, like I said before, God is calling us for fellowship. Jesus didn't die so that just we wake up, when we feel something, we go, we ask for it, we get it, and then we turn our back and we continue our way. God wants us. He wants us. He created us for his good pleasure, and he wants us 100%. And we have to want him back. You see, the amazing thing about God is that he gave us what they call free will. He loves you. He wants you. But it's up to you to say yes. And when you say that, you will enjoy it to a point that you will never believe. So he wants us for fellowship. And number two, when you walk with God, or let's say walking with God takes faith. The Bible says what? Without faith, it's impossible to please God. And when you walk with God, when we say walking with God, you have to please him in everything you do, right? But the first thing is faith. Believing in him, trusting in him. God is such compassionate. Jesus is our compassionate high priest. He's the one who intercedes for us. He said it first, that he's the way, the truth, and life. And anything we want from God, we just go to him. And the thing is also that he knows that we live in the flesh. Like I said before, the flesh wars against the things of the spirit. Sometimes you will fall. But just be open before God. In the Bible, you'll see people who have been called blameless when they walk with God. But it didn't mean that they were sinless. Look at David. God called him the man after my own heart. But he committed crimes that none of you, I believe, have ever committed. So Jesus is always there to respond for us. So in Philippians, let me read this for you. I love it. Philippians 3, 8 to 9, he says, "Yet indeed, I also count all things loss for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, from whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ, and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is from the law," because it was Paul talking, "but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness which is from God by faith." Faith in Christ alone allows us to access God. We cannot access God without faith. We cannot please him, I said before, without faith. Which means God loves faith. It's not what we do. It's not our accomplishment. God loves faith. And we need to have it. We need to believe it. And, you know, it says also, yeah, when you go to God by faith, you have to believe that what? He is. And he rewards those who diligently seek him. God is pursuing us. We have to seek him. We live in a moment now which is, I would call, dangerous. We don't even know how it's going to be the weeks to come, the months to come, next year. But I can promise you one thing. When you abide in the shadow of the Almighty, when you walk with him, you allow yourself to be covered by him, nothing will move you. I tell people, you know, everything we are going through is hard, but for me, we're living in exciting times. Because when you trust God, he will show up, and he shows up. He shows up. Personally, in my family, some of you know our stories. We've been through things with our son. But because of God, in his 13 years, this year has been the best year he's ever had. This year, the best year he's ever had. Is he totally out of the woods? When you look at him, we'll say no. But we know beyond the shadow of a doubt that he who has started it in him, he's faithful to complete it. We are doing it, we are declaring it by faith. Walking with God requires faith. Let's talk about Job a little bit. You know the story of Job, right? Because we can't go through that. I will recommend you to go and read it. It's hard. But, yeah, it's a good story. Job walked with God. Job trusted God. But just because God wanted to show Satan that Job was a great guy. He allowed Satan, let's say, to destroy his life. And when he was in his tribulation, in his trial, his friends came to him and think that by telling him that he had some hidden wickedness, hidden sins, they wanted to show that they know better. But Job, who knew himself and knew that he didn't do anything wrong, even at that time, Job every year will go sacrifice to atone for the sins of his sons, his children. Because he tried to live in integrity before God. And when they were accusing him of everything, the only thing he said in Job 19:25-26, he said, "For I know that my Redeemer lives, and he shall stand at last on the earth. And after my skin is destroyed, this I know, that in my flesh I shall see God." Regardless of what he was going through, he knew that his life on earth was not the most important thing. He will see God. And that's the main thing for us. I don't know about you, but that's what it is. I don't know how I'll leave this earth, and I don't care about that. But the most important thing for me is where I'm going. Regardless of what you're going through, your eyes need to be on God. That's why we're called to walk in. And also I told you, sometimes you'll have to do it alone when you walk with God. You'll find yourself in some situations where everyone around you are doing things that you know are ungodly. Will you find within you the strength to tell them, "No, this I won't do"? You're working at a place, they want you to do something, they want you to things that you know is ungodly. Will you think about the money or think about God? And that one, I leave it to you. It depends on everyone, anyone, the way you see it. But sometimes walking with God, you have to do it alone. In the Genesis, God became angry at mankind and wanted to destroy the earth. And he called Noah, one of those blameless people who walked with God. And he told him, "Build an ark." And he gave him all the dimensions and everything. And by faith, he trusted God. He believed God. And he started doing it. And people make fun of him like crazy. But because of obedience, he did it. And the flood came. And those who were laughing stopped laughing. Yes. When you walk with God, you have to obey. Trust his word and obey. Obedience is a prerequisite for being with Jesus. Because Jesus told his disciples, "If you are my friends, you will do whatever I say." If we call ourselves believers, Jesus followers, we will do whatever he said. And God talked to us, right? God talks to everyone. And when you hear his voice, what do you do? Now, recently we studied this book, The Awe of God, from John Bevere. And he said something about obedience. Just 5 points. He said, obey God immediately. Obey God even if it doesn't make sense. Obey God even when you don't see a personal benefit. Obey God even if it is painful. Obey God to completion. Abraham, he was close to 100 years old. He didn't have a child. And God came and gave him a promise. And then they got a child. And then God said, Abraham, take your only son and go and sacrifice him for me. He didn't ask a question. He took Isaac. He went and he was about to sacrifice him when God said, stop, and gave him a lamb. The Bible didn't say anything that Abraham thought about it. But one thing I believe that he thought about it, he said, you know, even when his son asked him, where is the animal for the sacrifice? He said, God will provide. He believed that God will provide, that his son was not going to die. That's where we need to be when we walk with God. You have to trust him to the point, even when you don't understand. When it hurts you, you trust God, you obey him, even when you know that there's nothing good in it for you. That's how we walk with God. We live in a world today where many are seeking. Many want to know God. And we will see the only Jesus that they will probably come across through the way we carry ourselves, the way we show that faith, the way we trust God. Obedience, never forget that. It's paramount. It's a prerequisite to be Jesus' friend. When you walk with God, your life needs to be like an open book to him. Sometimes we hide things, thinking that he doesn't know about it. He doesn't see it, but he does. There's nothing hidden before God, but he loves it when you fall and you go to him and you confess it. And we need to do that. The more we do it, the closer we get to him. I told you before, Noah, Job, David. Sometimes they call them blameless, but they were not blameless. But they lived with integrity. They lived with honesty before God. It's very, very important for us, okay, to focus our eyes on Jesus. Because the only true peace we will have in our heart when we go to trials, tribulations, is the peace that comes from Jesus. And when you keep your eyes on him, he will keep you in perfect peace. That's why walking with him, having an intimacy with God, is very important. When you walk with him, when you have that intimate relationship with God, what happened? Like I said before, you will trust him. You will obey him. You will love no matter what. You won't be one of those who always want to react when somebody does something to you. You will forgive. You will allow the Holy Spirit to lead you. You will not quench him. And you will not grieve him. Quenching the spirit. That's the spirit want to do something you don't want. Or the spirit is guiding you to do something you don't want to do. Or you are not allowing him to flow. Grieving, you go, you do things that go against the spirit in you. We all have the spirit in us. Let's behave the right way. Let's walk, because we are getting into, let's say, a period or a season where things are going to get harder out there. And you are called to carry the light. You are called to carry Jesus. Darkness will spread more. But you're not from the darkness. When you walk with God, when you have that intimacy with him, you will be bold. You will not compromise. Your belief and trust in God will make your decisions for you. You will not allow the flesh. Sometimes you will subdue the flesh. It's not an easy thing, but the way you subdue it, when you resist him, it will come to a point where he will flee from you. You live in the flesh, but the flesh will not control you. Nothing will shake or move you. You walk with God, his words will transform you. You'll be surrounded by trials. You'll be surrounded by tribulations. But when you take your eyes off the problems, set them on God, he will always meet you there. When you walk with God, when I talk about his word, you have to study the word. You have to learn to know God more, right? And for you to become biblically literate, because you need to know the God you serve, the God you walk with. And when you are at that point, you will not miss out on what he has for you. Because God wants you to know him. The more you walk with him, the more you'll know him. The more you walk with him, the more revelation he gives you. And I said this before, we should not see God as someone we come to only when we are in need. We need to go to God even when everything is rosy. It has to be a 24/7 thing. That's how we need to walk with God. You know, the enemy is going around looking for whom he may devour. And sometimes we open the door for him. But my question to you is, where you are now, if either the enemy shows up or God comes, in what posture will they see you? If God comes right now, because it's not when you worship, we are worshiping or everything. God reads the heart. It's not what we are doing. He reads the heart. What is your heart's posture right now? or when you live here. Are you in some sort of battle right now? Many are. Do you have people that you need to forgive? I'm sure many have. Are there things that you do that you know deep inside that you shouldn't be doing? It happens. So I believe that tonight, what I would like us to do, and I'm landing the plane, I would like to call Worship Nation to come. We are going to spend about 5 minutes just before God, giving Him our hearts. We are going to ask Him to come and search us. And you know, God always will reveal it to you where you're at. And you know where you need to be. Just know that you have it in you. You have the power of God in you. And God is craving that intimacy with you. And you need to seek Him with all your heart. So first, let's all stand up. And let's pray a prayer first. Before, I'm just going to open the altar for you. Come and just give your heart to Him. Let's put all our hands on our hearts and pray. Lord Jesus, let's all pray. Lord Jesus, I'm here before you tonight. And I know that I'm not perfect. And I know that I'm not doing it the way you want me to. Tonight, I bring my heart to you. Search me, O Lord. Reveal to me anything in me that you don't like. I want to walk with you. I want to know you. I want to serve you. I want to be your friend. I thank you that my life is in you. And you dwell in me. I pray tonight that my body, which is your temple, reflects you the right way. Come and have your way in me. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Can we do some worship for about 5 minutes?
I just want you and nothing else.
Yes.
And nothing else. And nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. No, nothing else. Nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else, Lord.
Nothing else.
Yeah, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else.
Nothing else.
I just want you. Just want you. Your presence,
just wanna sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never wanna leave. And I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. Just your presence.
Yes, Lord.
Nothing else will do.
Thank you, Father.
I just want.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for overwhelming us here with your presence, Lord. We don't want to live away from you. Father, we want to feel your warm embrace. We want to feel your presence every single day in our lives, Lord. Father, we say yes to intimacy. We say yes to your fellowship. We say yes to your relationship, Lord. I pray, Lord, that you bless each and every one of your sons and daughters here tonight, Lord. Father, take them to new heights. Take them to new levels. Reveal yourself to them as they are reaching out to you, Father. Just take them by the hand and walk with them. Father, we declare in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, that you'll meet them where they're at, Lord. That you, the God of breakthrough, Lord, you will give them, Lord, everything they need, Lord. And you will continue to fight their battles for them, Lord, while they're walking with you, enjoying your love, enjoying your presence. Oh, Father, we thank you tonight. We praise you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now we are going to open the altar. If you need prayer, please come. We have some prayer team. No, I don't think so. But at least I have. Do you need prayer? Come.
We worship you, Jesus. Your presence is heaven.
For the rest of you, have an amazing rest of the week, and we hope to see you here Sunday. God bless you, and don't forget, God loves you and wants to have an amazing time with you. Amen. Again, thank you so much. Love you.
just to be close to you.